Half a day, one model, two looks, and here's how we did the lighting. Hey guys, welcome to Phlearn. My name's Aaron Nace. You can find me on Twitter at AKNace. Today we're taking a look behind the scenes at how we did a recent shoot involving one model with two completely separate looks, and we're gonna show you how we did the lighting for each of them. So the concept was to bring a model into the studio, get two interesting shots out of it with two interesting lighting setups, but not take a whole long time to do it. So we did both of these looks in under 4 hours. So the first shot we're gonna talk about is the jump shot, and photographing someone from full body is quite different from photographing just a portrait. First of all, when you're using a portrait, you don't have a whole lot of area, so your lighting modifiers tend to be a little bit smaller. You can get away with smaller reflectors and beauty dishes and things like that. If you're photographing a large area, like a whole scene, or someone at full body, you need slightly larger lighting modifiers, and they're gonna create a more even look across the subject. So in order for it to look natural, we were going for a little bit like a stormy, cloudy day in which a little bit of light would be actually coming from above. Now, obviously this is shot in a studio. It doesn't look like it's natural light, but we did want a large light source to come from above. So that's why we put a parabolic reflector all the way, completely above our subject, and that's boomed out. That's actually the main light in the shot, and that's what creates the look that we can see, kind of gives the entire top of our subject that really nice rim and highlights things like the hair detail and all the fur and even the dirt flying around. Once we had our subject comfortable with the direction that they were gonna be jumping, we decided we needed a couple more lights that would kind of outline their facial features a little bit. We wanted something that was gonna really catch in their eye to separate them out from everything else that was going on, as well as provide a little bit more of that rim light. To create that catch light, we put a 7-inch reflector off to the camera left, and that's just shining directly into the subject's eyes. So that is going right here and really carving their face out from everything else. For the rest of the rim, we used another parabolic, and that's off to the camera left as well. So we've got those two lights off to the camera left. One's just a small point light going directly to our subject's face, and the other is quite a bit larger, and that's just really creating that nice rim. Now, when we started the shoot, all we had was the light on the top and then the two there on the left. The right we were leaving completely blank, and that would be a lot more like what natural light does. Natural light tends to kind of come from one direction, so it was like, top and from one side. The problem was we were not really getting much detail there on the camera right, so we decided to add another softbox, this time just a small softbox, and we brought the power pretty far down on that. So it's not a light that really like carves out the subject, it doesn't accentuate much the subject, it just adds a little bit of detail there where it was going almost completely black. For our lighting, we're using Paul Buff Einsteins. The flash duration on those is extremely short, meaning the time in which the flash fires goes all the way up to full intensity and then back down to zero is a very, very short amount of time. So what it does is it's very good at capturing movement. And anytime you're having someone, jump in the air or doing some kind of action and you want to freeze it, you want to make sure your flash durations are very short. To make the shot a little more interesting, we decided to add some thick sand into the mix that would make it look like almost like he's jumping through an environment. So the sand we sprinkled on his shoulders and on his head before every single shot and even put some of it in his hands. So as he's jumping through the shot, he kind of releases that sand and it flows all the way back behind him. Now in post-production, we're gonna photograph even more sand, this time on its own, and add that to the shot to make it really look like he's kind of jumping through a mixture of sand and rocks to really add a lot of interest to the shot. Here's another secret. We use baby oil in a lot of our shoots. We put a little bit of baby oil on the skin of our subject, and that really helps define their skin a little bit better. So those nice highlights you see carved out with his muscular frame, those are because of the baby oil. Anytime we get a model in our studio, we really love to take advantage of the time. So that means usually getting a couple different shots, even if the model's, the same model, same wardrobe and everything, but it'll just give you a little bit more variety. And when publishing these images, it gives you a little bit more of a story to kind of go behind. So in this case, we talked about the jumping shot, and that was kind of our action shot. The second shot is more of like the pensive shot. Maybe this is the night before, he's thinking about how he's going to be conquering his enemies or whatever, but this is gonna be our pensive shot. So for this shot, we really did want it to look a little bit more natural as well, but still pretty dramatic. So we're lighting it again from the top and from the sides, but all of our lighting modifiers go down in size because we're not photographing his entire body. The lighting from above, instead of being a giant 86-inch parabolic reflector, we actually used a much smaller light. This is a 7-inch reflector, and it has a 40-degree spot grid. So that spot grid really directs the light. Instead of the light going out at a thick beam like this, it really kind of directs it in just so it's gonna hit the top of our subject's head, not even much on their shoulders. Now, the lighting power was turned down in this. We didn't want it to be like, you know, something that was really calling a lot of attention to the top of his head, mostly just for those details. So now that we have our hair light in place, what we want to do is carve out the rest of his face with light. And oftentimes, if you're lighting a subject, if you can put a light right in front of their subject, they're going to be bright, they're lit, but it's not really going to be that interesting. So playing around with the shadows and the highlights is a lot of fun. And to do that, we need to light kind of a large area of our subject, but we still need to control the fall off. In other words, we wanted to dictate where the light went from light all the way into shadow. And to do that, we use two lights. The first light is back behind our subject, and that's just a medium-sized softbox. Now that's lighting most of the subject from behind, but the real important light here is the beauty dish. And that's a little bit off to the side, and it's got a 40-degree spot grid on it as well. So that grid, just like the grid on the hair light, is directing the light right to where we want it. So we can decide, you know, if we move it slightly to the right or the left, it's either gonna bring the, you know, the shadow highlight line, you know, from here to here to here. Each of those is gonna give you a completely different effect. So the combination of those three lights, each of which is really focused, gives us a great portrait that it gives some detail, but it doesn't give you too much information. So it doesn't give away the whole story. You're still kind of left guessing at what else is there. So here's a cool trick. If you want someone to look kind of like pensive and emotional, just have them look at the floor. It's a really simple trick, and it works on trained models as well as untrained models. Just have them kind of like look down and drop their chin, and it works pretty much every time. I probably look pretty depressed right now, so that's good. So that's both of our lighting setups in a nutshell. It's really cool to be able to bring a model on set, have one specific look, and then when we're done with that, just switch up the lighting a little bit and get a completely different look out of your subject and not take a whole lot of time doing it. To achieve drama, we tend to light people from behind instead of from the front, but that's just how we do it. How do you guys go about achieving drama in your photo shoot? Let us know in a comment down below. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I'll Phlearn you later. Bye, everyone.